Here we go. Hey Cass, thanks for being here. We are now on our second session for the Get Well webinars, and the idea is that we are promoting some wellbeing services that are in our local area in Gippsland. Before we start, I would like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land that I'm on today, which is actually Gunai Kurnai country. I'm down in the valley today in my car doing this, not that you can tell. So I live in a town that is now known as Warragul. And I'd like to acknowledge that that is, as far as local community has informed me, is Kurnai country. So I would like to acknowledge that and welcome to country. I'd like to acknowledge that and also say that a welcome to country carries with it instructions on how to keep country safe and how to stay safe whilst visiting. Even though I live, play, and run an outdoor service on Kurnai country and visit Gunai Kurnai country, I've never been formally welcomed to this country. So I'd like to acknowledge the privilege that I now receive as a non-Indigenous Australian as a result of invasion on this land where sovereignty was never ceded. And also, I like to recognise the irony that my income is directly sourced from introducing people to the outdoors, nature, and adventure. I'd like to acknowledge that I don't know enough about this country, that I'm not connected to local mob, and that I need to continue to educate myself on how to be respectful to country and cohabitate here with traditional custodians in a mutually beneficial way. I'd also like to acknowledge the countries that you are joining us from, if they're different to where we are today, and respectfully thank any First Nation people for being here. And Vanessa, thanks for joining us. Really, really good to have you here. Hi. I'm going to pass over now to Cass. Cass Fry is the founder of Bona Vista Equine Assisted Learning. And Cass is going to give us a short intro to what Bona Vista Equine Assisted Learning is and tell us everything we need to know. So over to you, Cass. Hopefully you've got control too.
Yeah, I think I do. Hello. Hi, Vanessa. Hi, Doug. Thank you so much for having me. And what a beautiful way to start. Thank you. That welcome to country was beautiful. So I'm on Gunai Kurnai land as well out in Bona Vista. So just in the foothills of the Stress Lakey Ranges. And that picture up on screen is my little dog, Biscuit, who is sitting on her bed by the fire, and Evie, my horse, myself, and my son when I first started this business. I just wanted to start with talking a little bit about myself because I am the business. So I'm the only human who works at here, as well as my family, my partner and my little boy live on the property too. But I do the work with people and the ponies and all of the space. So yeah, my name's Cass, 35, have worked in mainstream education for a really long time, and have stepped away to do this beautiful work. I feel like all of my passions are just combined into this beautiful work with craft and nature and horses, and yeah, it just feels really right for me. I started my education doing outdoor ed stuff, my journey, so that was pretty cool. It connected a little bit to Doug. But I found out that I wasn't a hardcore outfitter. I got a bit burnt out in that role, so standing in a paddock, hanging out in a very calm and relaxing environment is more my jam. So glad that I can have found my kind of true self, and now I can share that with other people, which is really rewarding. I'll show you our animals along the way too. There'll be some slides coming. Biscuit and Orbit are my two dogs. They have free range of the property. They're always around unless, of course, people aren't so comfortable with dogs. Evie's our littlest pony there. I have Daisy, who's a big grey Connemara, and Zuzu, who is Daisy's baby. Will the cow and three chickens, Karen, and Sharon. And we have two baby goats too, Herbie and Sherby, who are just divine and beautiful. So yeah, whilst we are equine assisted learning, we do still have lots of other beautiful members of our herd. So what is EIL? So it's a picture of one of our young clients having a really beautiful moment with Daisy the horse. Nice to see Vanessa. She's been doing a leading experiment, and it looks like in the background there's some obstacles. So maybe she walked around obstacles and then stopped and had a bit of time to reflect with the horse. So equine assisted learning is working with individuals to overcome life's challenges, whatever they may be, with the support of the horses and nature. So we work in partnership, myself, the client, and the horses or animals and nature. We're all kind of on the same level and just doing in this together. The goals can be, they're so open. We can tailor to like NDIS goals or like education goals, or, you know, just personal, social, emotional. There's lots of stuff that we can support people with through this amazing work. We always at the start of a session, so we have a few different ways that we can work. We have kind of two options for one-on-one. This is a one-on-one session here, and I'll tell you a bit more about our group programs too. But in the one-on-one sessions, we can do just like a set kind of, you know, 6 to 8 weeks program where we have a different goal and different theme for each week. So there might be social skills, communication, maybe relationship, boundaries, and they'll be set out before the client arrives. So that's one kind of way we can work. Or the other way could be just like kind of like ongoing one-on-ones, and then we do some soft contracting at the start as the client arrives. Hey, what's going on in your world? What would we like to work with today? So that's a bit more open and, yeah, a bit more supportive for those people who have stuff pop up between the time that they aren't here. We can do one-on-ones like weekly, fortnightly, or monthly, depending on the client's needs and wherever kind of they're at. I find the littler people work well weekly, so that we're still really fresh in their minds. And yeah, stretching that out to whatever it suits the person and, you know, their funding and plans and they're paying privately or whatever that might be. Yeah, I think that's it for that one. I'll do questions at the end, but if you do have anything that pops up, just let me know.
Sure thing.
Who, what, where, and when. So this image is summer last year with a friend's little boy who came out. You can see the grass is really dry. And me with blonde hair, don't have blonde hair at the moment, standing in the paddock, engaging with the young person. And I can see a little Evie bottom in the background. And that's Daisy standing right with us. And I can see some little Zuzu, baby Zuzu legs too. I don't know if you can see, I can't point, but they're in there. That one was when Zuzu was quite small. Who? Beagle is for anyone. So any age and any stage of their life, you know, so open. I've worked in lots of different spaces. There's nothing that I haven't, you know, heard or nothing that will shock me. We can work with all sorts of people or whatever, you know. We offer age-appropriate experiences for private or NDIS clients. So what might be showing up and happening in a teenager's world will be very different from a six-year-old or then, you know, a personal development business person or whatever that is. So we're really aware that all of our sessions need to be tailored to the person who shows up. I just realised I can't see my little, there I go, couldn't see my what. What it looks like is, as you saw earlier, like leading, brushing, padding in this photo behind us here. We're just hanging out and just chatting with the in nature with the presence of horses and giggling. It's like something funny happened. We might be padding or maybe just observing too. So noticing that everybody has different boundaries and different skill sets and different awareness around being around big animals and within themselves. So there's absolutely no pressure to get in there and be right up close with the animals. We can do an observation depending on their abilities as well. You know, some people aren't up for that. And, yeah, as I say, in there we can care for the horses, chickens, goats, dogs, and Mr. Cow, Mr. Will the Cow. I don't offer ridden sessions. It's not something that sits well with me or my herd. But there are other people who do. So if it's riding that you're interested in, then I'm more than welcome to refer on to people who do the riding. But we just find it's not really, it's not necessary in our work. Whereabouts? So touched a bit on that earlier. Our little piece of paradise is in Bona Vista. We're about 10 minutes out of Warragul. I think it's actually 8, depending on which way you go. And Yarragon too, so kind of like right in the middle. And not too far from Druin, so Druin's pretty close too. So
absolutely magical part of the world.
Yeah, I didn't know this part of the world existed until we moved out here. And I drove out here, I was like, what is this? What is this? So yeah, green rolling hills, and no matter which way you come, you can kind of come two ways from Warragul. It's just, yeah, it's a very, very nice looking and nice feeling environment. So yeah, we're very lucky to have this little space. We have 1 hour appointments available during the day. Pretty booked up in the afternoons at the moment, because I do tend to work with lots of younger people who want to come after school. We do have some group programs available as well, and I make some of those in after school hours or during the school day, you know, 9 to 5 kind of day for nature play we do with little people, so like babies up to school age. We also run some full day programs in the school holidays, or just kind of whenever they get scattered in between our one-on-one sessions. But one-on-one is probably our like core kind of work. And I speak about it is just me as a human, but my animals are part of it and nature. So I can't say I, because it just doesn't feel right. So I read a post the other day about, you know, it has to be I am the business, because I am, but it's us, because we're all in it together.
You're the herd.
Yeah, me and the herd. I'll cover everything. Investment and the price for our different sessions. So EAL sessions are 45 minutes is $80, and then an hour is $106. And then some clients opt in for a bit longer to really sit in and enjoy that regulation and mindfulness and the calmer kind of environment out of their maybe wild world. Group programs vary depending on what our staffing is like or what is going on in that group, but usually about 200 to 400 for a term, and they're about an hour a week, but that kind of changes term to term as well. And I'm studying nature-based therapy, and so is somebody who helps us out, which is amazing, and I'm loving that. So that is coming soon.
Exciting.
Yeah, and with that kind of, you know, we're always in nature out, like we do have a little teepee and a shed and stuff if it's horrendous weather, but you know, nature has such a big part of what we do already. I just wanted to talk through some pickies, because I'm a really visual learner, so I need to kind of see it to see what it is.
Yeah, it looks great.
Yeah, so top, is it left with the three horses and the dog? Is that the same thing? Yeah, with a adult client there, you can see that that person's just observing from the outside, and they're doing the equine assisted learning work. That's Orbit, the big goofy GSP who teaches us lots about personal space. He doesn't have a huge amount of personal space. And he's also really, he's a really big character. So he will take himself way, way, way away when he's feeling a bit overwhelmed. So I call him my little neurodivergent child, because he just looks after his own needs whenever, whatever they are. And yeah, has no idea of personal space. And I don't think he ever will learn that, but that's kind of part of who he is. So we accept and welcome his beautiful personality. Which way should I go? I might go down. So we've got a preteen, tween client there, hanging out with Evie in summer, doing some leading and some brushing and some chatting too, and just getting to know little Miss Evie. The top person in the dress with an orange jumper is leading and feeding. Who is that? That is Sherby. So Sherby, our little baby goat, our little niece. She has a really huge fear of dogs, so working up to hanging out with the dogs so the dogs are away when she comes. And then the goats have this beautiful way of working that is kind of similar to horses, similar to dogs, kind of show up with lots of different stuff to teach our people. So, yeah, she's getting to know the goats, which is pretty cool. I need to move ourselves again so we can see. Next to my logo to the left is the CAS tent. So CAS's Academy of Zen is been named by one of our clients, my Academy of Zen, which we love.
Yeah.
I don't think I put a photo of inside. That was silly of me. But there's stuff on my social media. So if you want to have a look inside the tent, you're so welcome to. It's a little bit people always get really excited to look in there. And out the front of it, we have nature play area, so lots of different textures and spaces. There's, I also did take a photo of the river. So we have a little water feature just behind us there and a mud kitchen to do lots of mixing and pouring and stirring, and there's a sand pit in there too. So lots of different things for people to get involved in and find their own little space. And that is just a beautiful space that gets really buzzing with calm, energetic, inflow energy when we have groups there. Everyone's just doing whatever that it is that they need to. And parents being able to step away as well. It doesn't matter if it gets messy, like whatever they create and however they play then sets up for the next group of people who come, and then, oh, they find this little bits of pipe that are connected or some stepping stones or whatever it is. So, that's one of our new additions. Yeah, that's cool. Why I can't just call it me, because, you know, look at that space. It has so much to teach us and so much to work with. Yeah. And then in the tent, there's lots of learning resources too. So books and puzzles and games and lots of sensory things. And in the tent, it's all really kind of take away a bit of the outside world and can just really come back into ourselves. Sitting on the ground, so it's quite relaxing and grounding. And for some people, they, you know, forget that sitting on the ground can be really powerful and grounding and just being. Our little people and our bigger people who come and hang out with us really find that a very supportive space. This butterfly up here come to hang out with us one day in nature play, right when we're talking about butterflies. It just like flew right in and
Get
a gig. Look how beautiful it is. I don't know much about butterflies, but I know it's beautiful and I like that. And then we have Fairy Bronnie and Zuzu. Baby Zuzu's getting a bit bigger in this photo. And one of our tween group program participants. That one's Magical Mindfulness Moment. So you can have a look at my flyers on my social media. That's an after school program, and we do lots of magical things. So some of our people call Beeville the magical place, which I love. And we just build on that. So, you know, clients are talking about how much magic we have. So we're making it extra magical. And just listening to the community and what they want and what they need. So Fairy Bronnie is a fabulous addition to the team, and she might make some potions. We talk about mindfulness, but in a really age-appropriate, fun, magical, engaging way. So do all sorts of crafty activities and making and doing lots of things. And then up in the top right is the calm corner, so a bit of an opportunity to do some swinging or some sitting or some resting or some awareness work with the beautiful things hanging from the trees, little hammock and some lovely chairs that are really snuggy. We talk about what your body needs a lot of the time. So we've got a laneway, so you can do some zooming if your body has lots of big energy, or we have, you know, some really calm, crazy corners if you feel like just being a bit of a hermit for a little bit. And everything in between. So just kind of teaching everybody that it's okay to do whatever your body kind of needs, and bringing awareness to what is it that my body needs right now if I'm not doing so great. And then our little people engaging in nature play. Looks like they've got some food out. So we might have been talking about, looks like they've made some sand pizza things, maybe some mud pies with a beautiful magical twist. There'll probably be sparkles in there, I'm assuming. And we would have been talking about like healthy eating and linking that into, you know, playing and nature rainbow plates, and there's all sorts of wonderful goals and stuff that we can work on through play and through just immersing yourself in the space. I'm just going to check my notes to make sure that I've covered.
That's lovely.
Those things. I think I have. And then the last one is just my contact details, and Daisy and Evie and the puppies. So my phone number's on there, my email address, I'm on social media, so as like the full name, Bona Vista Equine Assisted Learning on Facebook, and on Instagram, BV Is that an underscore? Underscore? E-A-L. Yeah, I think that's kind of, in a bit of a nutshell, who we are and what we do. So, yeah, any questions or thoughts or comments?
I wonder, Cass, if it's worth just mentioning, because maybe people see equine-assisted and they think equine-assisted therapy. I wonder if it's maybe worth just giving like a quick little insight as the difference between what you're doing and what therapy is. Obviously, yes, from what you've just shown us, like that's given us a really great insight that it is, you know, it's everything from mentoring to being outside in a safe space, learning how to interact with animals, learning to be self-aware, learning to be observant of what's going on. But maybe it's worth just noting, some key differences.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So I'm equine assisted learning practitioner, and we do have through the EPI, which is the organisation, registered under IICT. So it's a holistic alternative support. And the difference between EAL, so learning, versus EAP, which is equine assisted psychotherapy. So that's the therapy side, and I'm the learning. Is that we work with the here and now. So whatever is going on, we just work with now. Yep. And we redirect back to, you know, there's stories that come up from the past or the history of origin. I'll just redirect back to how can we support you right now in this moment? So we don't need to unpack or go into any, you know, I'm not going to be opening any big dark cupboards. That's for the psychotherapists and for psychologists and stuff to unpack. Yeah, so, and that's in our agreement. So I talk to all of our clients when they first arrive that's what it is. And then the equine assisted psychotherapy or the therapy is, it's the same model, but just one extra step where they might go into the history of origin if that feels right for them, or they might not, depending on the client. So yeah, thanks, Doug. That's a really good one to point out that that's the difference. Yeah.
Perfect. And what's the best way of people getting in touch with you to refer or to book in a session? Email good or?
Yeah, email's probably best. I'm often in the paddock out doing stuff. So I'm not great at, like, if you catch me on a phone call, like, well done. But I'm usually between doing other things. So a email is best, and I'm pretty active on social media. So I will get back to messages within a couple of days. Phone calls too, if you're a person who likes to chat and likes to chat about it and wants to get to know me a bit and wants to have a bit more of a conversation about who you're referring or chat to me before you come out, that's totally okay too. But yeah, email's probably best, and then we can work out where to go from there.
Lovely. Thanks. And you can cater for NDIS participants, open to members of the public. Referrals from third party agencies such as maybe youth wellbeing agencies, schools, etc. So anybody can come and access BVEL. What's BVEL? There you go. Bona Vista Equine Assisted Learning. We're just putting
it right in there. I know it's so long, but like it makes sense. Like it's where I am and it's what I do. That was like done. So yeah, I call it BVEL, but
no, it works.
Choose your own adventure with that.
Awesome.
I was going to ask also, is there an age limit?
No, not really. I have a EAL one-on-one client who's 3, and I've worked with someone who's 63. So as long as people can kind of get around. Yeah. I haven't had anyone in a wheelchair come out yet, but I'm open to that. But, yeah, it's just all age appropriate. So we'll cater for whatever it is of that person. And then for really, really little people, I have a nature play program, which we hang out in that beautiful space with the tent and stuff. So yeah, there's no age limit and I kind of say like any age and any stage. So wherever they're at, got lots of nonverbal, got lots of, lots and lots of different complex stuff going on. And that's totally okay, because we just meet you where you are and the animals, and I see you for the wonderful person that you are. So
And so it can be wheelchair accessible as well, did you say?
Yeah, I haven't had anyone out, but I reckon we could make it work. I don't have luck up the others. We'd have to make sure that it all works, but I'm open to that, and I think that it would be okay. We don't have like stairs, but it's all gravel or grass, so it's not, you know, it's not like a concrete building because we're outside in paddocks. But as long as they had a bit of full driving capacity, then we can make it work. But even where, so this photo where it's taken, there's the shed to the right and then just a ramp that goes to the parking area. So yeah, I have done some sessions in cars before when people didn't really want to get out of the car, so we can take the animals up to the car window and have a chat there. Yeah, really flexible, really breezy yeah. with whatever's going on. Yeah.
Amazing. It really sounds like you've got a service up there, Cass, that is so flexible for people just to rock up, and you sounds like you'll just do whatever it takes to engage them at a level that works for them.
Yeah,
which is brilliant.
Yes, it's magical. It's beautiful. Very, very grateful for this.
And you thought you were going to be finished in 2 minutes, and we've pretty much filled the entire half hour. So go us.
Yeah, I could. Anyone who wants to hear how fabulous it is, I will definitely tell you.
Because it is.
You need to come out. You need to feel it. I can just, you know, I hope that my passion comes through in the way I talk about this work. But it's, yeah, it's one thing to hear about it, but it's another thing to experience it and be right there with that.
I'm a coordinator for NDIS participants, clients. So are you, when you were saying you're open to people to come out, is that possible that support coordinators could come out and have a look just to make sure that it is, you know, suitable for
their clients? Yeah, I've definitely done that before. Yeah, yeah, come out and have a look around and I'll show you the space, give you a bit of introduction to if you've got like a few support workers that want to come out and see if it will be suitable for whoever they work with. And, yeah, absolutely, I've done that for a few people and, yeah, it's lovely to get to see, put faces to names as well. I'm a bit of a, social learner. Like, I make, visual learner. So emails, yes. I'm like, oh, once I meet you, I'm like, oh, yeah, yeah, forget it.
Yeah, I'm good, absolutely. Good. Because I like to, if I, you know, recommend or promote, you know, services, I like to see what I'm, recommending,
yeah.
I guess.
What you're endorsing, yeah, for sure.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So welcome to come on out. Yeah, just let me know.
Yep. Awesome. Perfect.
Great. Well, Cass, that's bringing us to half hour. So
Amazing. Unreal.
Unless you've got anything else to add, I think this is the perfect time for us to close it up. And we will, everyone that's registered for this, when I get my act together, we'll get a copy of the recording plus any program information that Cass has. It'll just go out as an email. So you'll get all of those details as well as Cass's contact details and, yeah, feel free to share amongst your networks.
Yeah.
So, Cass, thank you so much for being willing to do this, and Vanessa, thank you so much for coming and listening in live. And everyone,
thank you for having me.
Pleasure. Everyone that's registered, thank you so much. And we'll keep doing what we can for the Gippsland community.
Yeah. Thanks so much. Thanks for having me.
No. Cheers.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
You too. Bye.